Ciao a tutti, mi chiamo Sara e oggi studiamo gli articoli indeterminativi italiani. Hi everyone, my name is Sara and today we will study the indefinite Italian articles. Iniziamo! Let's start! In English, the indefinite articles are e, an, or some. In Italian, however, we have six different ones. Before you study the indefinite articles in Italian, I recommend that you watch my previous video about the definite articles in Italian. Very well, we can start now. In Italian, we always divide the articles into different categories: maschile, masculine, and femminile, feminine. Singolare, singular, and plural, plurale. So, when the noun is maschile, singolare, we can use the article un or uno. Un, uno. When the noun is maschile, singolare, and we use un, when it's plurale, we will use dei. Un becomes dei. When the noun is maschile, singolare, and we use uno, when it's plurale, we will use degli. Uno becomes degli. So basically same color. Un becomes dei. Uno becomes degli. I will explain when to use un or uno in the next slides. However, if you watched the previous video about the definite articles, you will know that it's the same rule. Very well. When the noun is femminile, singolare, we will use una. When it becomes plurale, delle. Una becomes delle. Very well, let's see some examples. Tavolo. Tavolo ends with o, so it's maschile, singolare, so we will use un. Maschile, singolare, un tavolo, plurale, un becomes dei, dei tavoli, un tavolo, dei tavoli. Casa, casa ends with a, so it's femminile, singolare, so we will use una. Una casa, una casa, plurale, delle, delle case, una casa, delle case. This is to compare the definite article, the, with the indefinite article, e and some. So if you notice, when the definite article is il, when we use an indefinite article, it will always be un. Il, un. When we use lo, we will always use uno. So lo becomes uno. Same goes for the plural. If we use I, the plural will be dei. If we use gli, the plural for the indefinite article will be degli. Very well, you can find here the rules when to use un or uno. So we use un for words that begin with a consonant. We use uno for words that begin with S plus consonant, Z, PS, or Y. Uno becomes un without apostrophe when the following word starts with a vowel or an H. Una becomes un apostrophe when the following word starts with a vowel or an H. Let's see some examples. Un libro. Libro starts with a consonant, so we will use un libro. Plural, dei libri. Zaino. Zaino also starts with consonant, however, is part of the special rule. Z. So we will use uno. Uno zaino. Plural degli zaini. Albero. Albero starts with the vowel. Here, vowel. So it should be uno albero, but since it starts with a vowel, we delete the O and we don't put any apostrophe. Un albero. Plural degli alberi. Mela. Una mela. Plural delle mele. Porta. Una porta. Plural delle porte. Anguria. Anguria starts with a vowel. So it should be una anguria. However, we use the un with apostrophe. So, una anguria. Plural delle angurie. Un'anguria, delle angurie. Very well, I hope that everything is clear. If you have any question, please write it down in the comment. And if you like the video, put a like. Thank you very much and alla prossima! See you next time! Ciao!